We are ready to begin our mini-lesson on drafting subtopic 1 of the research essay. At the last class, you organized your research note cards into subtopics. Subtopic 1 and subtopic 2 for most of you, and some of you even had a subtopic 3. Today, you will be using your note cards. Under your first subtopic on slide 7, that would be subtopic 1, slide 7 of your research notebook, you'll be using these note cards to draft the body paragraphs for subtopic 1 of your essay. So here are the steps to developing body paragraphs. Before I go through these steps, I want to point out that subtopic 1 of your research essay is almost like a mini essay. So you are going to pretend like this is the essay that you're writing about. In order to get a 5 out of 5 for subtopic 1, when we do our research check-in, you need to have a minimum of 2 body paragraphs for subtopic 1. So let's begin. What are the steps for developing body paragraphs? Step 1, create a guiding question for subtopic 1. To help you stay on topic, it's very easy to get off topic. So if your subtopic 1 is causes of depression, your question could be, what are some causes of depression? You want to make sure that you have a question that you are specifically seeking to answer in subtopic 1. And it's really easy to turn your subtopic 1 into a question. Step 2, you will now begin drafting the paragraph. Just like with any other essay, a body paragraph must begin with a topic sentence. And in this case, your topic sentence should clearly address your question for subtopic 1, and it must make a provable and defendable point. So whatever you say in your topic sentence, it has to be a point that you can prove through research and defend through your explanation and analysis. Step 3. Use your research. You'll find this on your note cards in your research notebook. Use your research to explain, prove, justify, and/or clarify the point in your topic sentence. So your topic sentence makes a point. And now in the rest of the paragraph, you need to prove that point or explain that point or justify that point. Step 4, and this is very important in a research essay, make sure you include the in-text citation or the parenthetical citation after all researched information. So when you take information from that note card, make sure that you put the parenthetical citation after it. And finally, step 5. Provide an analysis of the research or information that connects the ideas and arguments logically. Please note that the analysis is your contribution to this essay. Without the analysis, without your ideas, your research essay is merely a compilation of other people's work. So the analysis is very important. I also want you to note that the analysis usually includes an appropriate closing. So if your analysis does not wrap up your thoughts effectively, you will need to include a concluding statement. Before I end this mini lesson, I want to go back to step 3, research note card. The majority of you chose to quote your research, which is fine. But in your essay, you should not have more quotes than you have analysis. So a lot of you are going to need to paraphrase these quotes from your note cards. So when you read the note card, don't just copy and paste. Read the content, type it in your own words, and then put the in-text or parenthetical citation. If you must quote, whatever you quote should not exceed one sentence. All right? So those are the steps to developing body paragraphs for subtopic 1.